Good afternoon, my dear students of Standard 6th. I hope that you all are safe and healthy. Welcome back to this online class learning after Christmas vacation and in this new year. Today, we are going to learn an interesting lesson of English, that is 3.27 Sisters. In this chapter, we are going to study about the seven states of Northeast India. They are called as the seven sisters as they are all sharing a common border with each other, and these states are little far away in India. People find it difficulty in traveling to these states. We will study about each and every state in detail. We will study about the interesting facts about the states. These states have a very beautiful scenery that anyone can imagine. It has lush green plains, beautiful waterfalls, valleys, snow peak, Himalayan ranges, wild animals, colorful costumes, etc. These states add a very grand beauty to the nature. We are going to study about each seven state in detail. So now let us go through the chapter about the seven sisters and what it is all about. So students, take out your textbook, turn to page number 51. Let us get started. Hello everyone. Have you guessed who we are? We are the seven sisters of Northeast India. Still unexplored, isolated territories to most of you and to the rest of the world. Our sister Sikkim lies to the north, but we seven sisters are contiguous to each other. We are famous for our natural beauty, lush forests and wild animals, as well as our colorful costumes, traditional jewelry, exotic flowers and our own unique dance and music. Nature lovers have designated our whole area as one of the world's biodiversity hotspots. So these seven sisters, that is the seven states, lie at the Northeast India. They are unexplored, isolated territories, that is, they are very lonely places. Most of the people don't visit over there as it is very far away in India. These seven sisters add a grand beauty to the nature. They are famous for natural beauty, lush forest, wild animals, then colorful costumes, traditional jewelry, exotic flowers, unique dance and music. They all have, these all states have a beautiful unique dance and music. They all have some of the other features or characteristics that we are going to study in this chapter. First one is Arunachal Pradesh. Hi, they call me the land of the rising sun, the land of the dawn lit sun. I am Arunachal Pradesh. My people are simple and hospitable. They belong to many tribes speaking their own languages. So Arunachal Pradesh is called as the land of the rising sun, the land of the dawn lit sun. Arunachal Pradesh, the people over there are very simple and hospitable. Hospitable means friendly. They are very simple and friendly. They belong to many tribes speaking their own languages. Means there are many small tribes. Like in Maharashtra, how small languages are there. Likewise, in Arunachal Pradesh, there are small tribes. That means small group of people, and they all have their own languages. Their diet is largely made up of rice with fish, meat and many green vegetables, and a popular dish is momos, steaming buns with meat or vegetable stuffing. So what is their diet? Their diet is made up of rice with fish, then meat and many green vegetables. They eat a lot of green vegetables. Their popular dish, that means the famous dish found over there, is momos. That means steamed buns. Means pow type. See over here, the fourth picture is given over there. Momo's picture is given over there. It is having a stuff of meat or vegetable. I am a nature lover's heaven. My land is spotted with monasteries, lush green forests, lakes, waterfalls and deep river valleys. In my limestone caves known as Tepenuru and forest reserves, you will find a great variety of wildlife. So Here, Arunachal Pradesh land is spotted with monasteries. Monasteries means temples or caves or even big huge palaces. So this Arunachal Pradesh, they are having monasteries. Then lush green forest, that means very greenery forest, lakes, waterfalls and deep river valleys. In their caves, known as the caves are known as Teponaru. There you will find a large variety of wildlife. Wildlife means wild animals you will find over there in that caves. You must take it a point to visit the 400-year-old Buddhist monastery at Tawang and enjoy cultural festivals at Zero. So there are a famous Buddhist monastery is been found. It was built 400 years ago at Tawang, and there are cultural festivals are celebrated at Zero. Don't miss the Namdafa Tiger project. You are also welcome to the many wildlife sanctuaries and national parks where you may see rare animals, birds and plants. I am also home to India's first orchid sanctuary. So here there is a project called as Namdafa. It is a project related to tigers. So that project is very famous. In that project related to tiger conservation is being given. So there are also many wildlife sanctuaries and national parks in Arunachal Pradesh where rare animals, birds and plants are found. Rare means not common. They are not commonly found anywhere. Only sometimes they are found. So in Arunachal Pradesh, wildlife sanctuaries and national parks where animals, birds and animals are found. So Arunachal Pradesh is also home to India's first orchid sanctuary. Next is Assam. Friends, I am Assam, also known as Ahom. You will find my land between the beautiful valleys of the Brahmaputra and Barak rivers. They call me the gateway to the seven sisters. So Assam is also known as Ahom. Whenever we hear of Assam, then we first come to mind is tea plantation. So in Assam, where is Assam located? It is located in a bit. Between the beautiful valleys of Brahmaputra and Barak rivers, means it is located between. At one side if it is Brahmaputra valley and another side it is Barak river. So it is located between Brahmaputra and Barak rivers. They call me the gateway to the seven sisters. Now gateway to the seven sisters. Why it is called? Because at one side it is Brahmaputra river and another side it is Barak river. So that is why it is called as the gateway to the seven sisters. My people are very hospitable. As we saw that Arunachal Pradesh also people were very hospitable. Means friendly. Over there also they were friendly. Here also in Assam also people are very friendly. If you come here, you can enjoy the cuisine which has its own distinctive aromas and flavors. Cuisine means special preparation. So every state is having special preparation. As we saw in Arunachal Pradesh, there were rice with fish, meat and green vegetables. Likewise in Assam also, there are special preparations which have distinctive aromas and flavors. Aromas means very nice flavor, very nice smell and very nice flavor food are being found in Assam. I am known for my artistic heritage, exotic dance forms and elegant temples. So in Assam we can see lot of temples, then the dance over there is also famous, and artistic heritage means the artistic heritage means the places where artwork are being done. The rivers ensures that my territory is lush and fertile with wetlands, orchards, tea estates and scenic forests and parks. So as I said that whenever we hear about Assam, first comes into our mind is about tea plantation. So over there tea plantation is very famous in Assam, and we can find orchards also over there with forests and parks. Parks, forest, tea estates. Tea estates means a lot of big farm is there where tea plantation is being done over there in Assam. Kaziranga National Park and Manas National Park are World Heritage Sites. So there are two national parks called as Kaziranga National Park and Manas National Park. they both are heritage sites, world heritage sites. Means people from the other countries or other states, they come and visit this place called as Kaziranga National Park and Manas National Park, because lots of animals, plants and birds are being found in these national parks. My picture's landscape of golden green rich rice fields and landscape tea estates is awesome to behold. And you know Assam tea is world famous. Yes, I have said that Assam tea is very world famous. It is famous in the world. And over there, that Assam, whenever we visit over there in Assam tree plantation, tea plantation, over it is a very beautiful sight to see the tea plantation being done over there. How the ladies and gents both they do the tree plantation over there. It is very awesome to see that. It is very beautiful. The Brahmaputra is Assam's lifeline. So Brahmaputra river is Assam's lifeline. Means Assam people all lead to Brahmaputra. Brahmaputra water is very famous for Assam people. The land is also rich in petroleum, natural gas, coal, limestone and other minor minerals. So in Assam we can get coal, natural gas, petroleum, limestone and other minerals. My hand woven silks are exquisite with natural colors and design. So the people over there, they weave clothes, the hand woven silks. That means the cloth which are hand woven, they weave from their hand. They are very beautiful and with natural colors and designs. Natural colors and designs means whatever is being obtained from the nature is being with that they do, with that they weave the silk and the clothes. They say our women weave fairy tales on their looms. Assam silk fabrics, eri, muga and pat are the most sought after silks in the world of fashion. I am known as the land of fairs and festivals. The major festival of Assam is Bihu. So the major festival of Assam is Bihu. They celebrate Bihu with very joy, and lot of people, they enjoy this festival. They dance and they all ladies and gents, they all enjoy this festival very well. Cane and bamboo are the inseparable parts of my life. As souvenirs, you can take the japi, that is the traditional sunshade and mask. Don't forget to visit the Ahom palaces. So over there, as souvenirs, souvenirs means a thing which we keep for ourselves as a remembrance of that place. So as souvenirs, that means as a remembrance of that you have visited Assam, we can keep as we can take japi, that is the traditional sunshade and mask, and the mask are available over there. We can take that as souvenirs. Don't forget to visit the Ahom palaces. The Ahom palaces over there are very famous, and if we go to Assam, then we have to visit that Ahom palace. Without visiting Ahom palace, the Assam visiting is not fulfilled. So Ahom palaces are very famous over there, that we are supposed to visit over there. So this is what is all about Assam. So now let us study about the third sister, that is Meghalaya. Hello friends, I am the abode of clouds, Meghalaya. My capital city, Shillong, is called Scotland of the East because of its highlands, fog and scenery. My people speak English, Khasi, Pnar and Garo. I am overwhelmingly beautiful and everything here is impossibly green and alive. The rolling mists in the valleys, the undulating hills, numerous lakes, waterfalls, caves, sacred forests and exotic flora and fauna. So Assam, this we have studied about Arunachal Pradesh and Assam. Now third we will study about Meghalaya. So the capital city of Meghalaya is Shillong, which is called as the Scotland of the East because of its highlands, fog and scenery. Over there the people speak English, Khasi, Nar and Garo. These four languages are spoken by the people of Meghalaya. Over there, we can find undulating hills, numerous lakes, then waterfalls, caves, forests, and flora and fauna. Flora and fauna, that means animals and plants and birds. Over there, lot of animals and plants are being found over there. And Meghalaya, over the place is very greenery over there. Whenever we go to Meghalaya, the place over there is very alive, and it is very beautiful over there. Here, Jhum and shifting cultivation is practiced even today. Jhum and shifting cultivation, they are the two types of farming which is practiced by the people of Meghalaya. I have lovely mountains with stretches of valleys and highland plateaus. The rock formations here contain rich deposits of valuable minerals like coal, limestone, uranium, and sillimate. I have many rivers. So in Meghalaya we can see we can find lovely mountains with stretches of valleys and highland plateaus. The rock formation here contain, that means we can obtain coal, uranium, limestone, sillimate in Meghalaya. We can obtain many other types of minerals also. Please come to see Cherrapunji or Mousindram, the wettest places on earth. You can enjoy the forests and sacred groves here. So this Cherrapunji and Mousindram, these are the two places in Meghalaya where we can find lot of plants, various types of plants over there. It is a forest type. It is a forest where we can find lot of varieties of plants, and even animals are being found over there in Cherrapunji and Mousindram. So Cherrapunji and Mousindram is famous in Meghalaya. I boast of several national parks and wildlife sanctuaries. Friends, you would be amazed to see the Krem Lad Kra, which is the longest cave, and Sindrang Pamyam, which is the deepest cave. So which is the longest cave? Krem Lad Kra, and deepest cave is Sindrang Pamyang. Here these two are the caves where lot of animals and lot of birds are being found in these caves. You can enjoy the panoramic view of Bangladesh from here. Do come to this Pine Fresh Mountain State during the Wangala festival in autumn. So whenever we visit Meghalaya, we can see a small view of Bangladesh from there. No need to go to Bangladesh. From Meghalaya only you can see Bangladesh view. In autumn, if we visit, then Wangala festival is famous, which is celebrated in autumn season, which lot of people enjoy this festival with dance, they sing, and they enjoy a lot. Now the fourth sister, that is Manipur. Hey, I am the fourth sister, Manipur, the jeweled land. So Manipur is called as the jeweled land. I am proud to be the jewel of my mother India. I am also known by my nicknames Kanglipek and Sanalibak. So the nicknames of Manipur is Kanglipek and Sanalibak. My capital is Imphal, where you can see the cyclist velodrome. Many of my people belong to the Miti ethnic group and speak Miti, that is Manipuri language. I have the credit of introducing polo to the Europeans. So the capital city of Manipur is Imphal, where we can see lot of boys and lot of people doing cycling over there. Many of the people, that is they belong to Miti group, and they speak Miti or Manipuri language. I have the credit of introducing polo to the Europeans. So in Manipur, people play polo. Polo is a game which is played by the people over there. It is being the people of Manipur, they play polo, and they have introduced this to the Europeans. This Europeans also play this game, which they have learned from Manipur state. माई पीपल्स स्टेपल डाइट कंसिस्ट ऑफ राइस फिश लार्ज वराइटीज ऑफ किवी वेजिटेबल्स बोथ एक्वेटिक एंड टेरिस्ट्रियल बट आर क्यूजाइन इज सो डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द रेस्ट ऑफ इंडिया ड्यू टू द यूज ऑफ वेरियस एरोमेटिक हर्ब्स एंड रूट्स दैट आर पेक्यूलर टू माई स्टेट नाउ एज एवरी स्टेट इज हैविंग मीट राइस वेजिटेबल्स लाइकवाइज इवन मणिपुर हैज राइस फिश एंड लीफी वेजिटेबल्स बट इन मणिपुर देर इज अ स्पेशलिटी ऑफ प्रिपेरिंग द डिशेज ओवर देर दे यूज स्पेशल हर्ब्स they use aromatic herbs which are naturally found in nature they use that and they make their dishes they make their special preparations which are very famous and which are very different from other countries or other states blessed with an amazing variety of flora and fauna I am home to host of rare endemic plant and animal life there A treat for the eyes in the Kibul Lamjau National Park, an abode of the rare and endangered species of roe or antlered deer. So, as we have seen that in Assam also, there were rare animals, birds and plants found. Likewise, in Manipur also, there birds and plants have been found in Kibul Lamjau National Park. It is a house or a home for endangered species of roe antler deer. That means it is a deer. It is a type of a deer. A type of a deer has been found in the Kibul Lamjau National Park, and the and very rare species are being found over there. This ecosystem contains 17 rare species of mammals. So how many species of mammals are found 17 rare species that means 17 uncommon species are being found over there it is the only floating national park of the world you should come to see the Loktak lake and floating islands our manipuri dance is one of the most acclaimed classical dances of india the folk dances of tribal people captivate the beholders with their exotic costumes and simple but graceful rhythm you should not fail to witness the manipuri martial arts tangta and sarit sarak so over there manipuri dance is very famous and people enjoy that dance it is one of the classical dance of india people adopt this dance as it is a classical dance and lot of tribal people enjoy this dance with the people they wear their special costumes they wear their special special attire and they dance and it is in a graceful rhythm they play a graceful tone and graceful rhythm where people dance in this tune then there are two arts of manipuri that is tangta and sarit sarak which is very famous in manipur Now next, that is the fifth sister is Mizoram. Hello, I am Mizoram. Mizoram implies land of the hill people referred to as the Kukis. I invite you to see my land of lush hills, sheer cliffs, serene lakes and waterfalls. Rolling hills stretch across hundreds of miles and the plains and valleys are covered with lush forests and thick bamboo groves. Green paddy fields, vineyards, teeming with diverse wildlife. My regret is that not any of you come to visit me. Well, traveling in Mizoram is a little difficult, but it has its own rewards. The natural beauty here is exquisite and must be seen to be believed. So in Mizoram, Mizoram is called as the land of the hill people. That means people over there are living on hilly areas and it is referred to as the Kukis as we have seen that in all the four sisters we had seen that there are lot of places like lush forests are there then hills are there waterfalls we have seen likewise in Mizoram also there are hills lakes and waterfalls being found over here then we can see forests thick bamboo groves paddy fields vineyards we can see over here in Mizoram. And Mizoram is feeling very regret because people don't visit Mizoram very often. Only few people visit Mizoram because it is difficult to travel in Mizoram. So people don't go to Mizoram also. But Mizoram is very beautiful, and it is very, very beautiful and very greenery that we should go and see. My capital is Aizawl, and from its scenic location, you can get a captivating view of lush Emerald Tuang River Valley in the west and Turial River Valley in the east. So the capital of Mizoram is Aizawl. Over there, two rivers are there. One river is situated in the west, that is Wang River, and another river, that is Turial River, is situated in the east. The museum in the heart of the city, Zarkwat, portrays the culture of Mizoram with a splendid collection of costumes, artifacts, and historical relics. So there is one museum in the heart of the city. That means heart of the city, that is Zarkwat, is the heart of the state Mizoram. That city is the heart of the state Mizoram. Where a lot of costumes, historical things, then artifacts are being found over there in that museum. People go there and visit to see the historical things and costumes of the olden days of the ancestors which they would have worn in that state. The Palak Lake is the biggest in Mizoram and covers 30 acres. So there is one lake called as Palak Lake. It is very biggest in Mizoram and it covers 30 acres. Do you know that it is believed that the lake was created as a result of an earthquake or a flood? So why was that lake created? Because of the earthquake or the flood. If earthquake or flood comes, then that lake was created because of earthquake or the flood. Champai, with its fertile vineyards, is known as the fruit bowl of Mizoram. So Champai, it is one of the fertile vineyards, is called as the fruit bowl. I am also host to numerous species of birds, wildlife, and flora. You can visit the two national parks and six wildlife sanctuaries here. Mizo is the official language and the most widely used language. So over there in Mizoram, there are a lot of birds, wildlife, and flora being found. As in all the sisters, we can see that a lot of birds, birds and plants are being found. So in Mizoram, there are two national parks, famous national parks, and six wildlife sanctuaries. And the official language is spoken in Mizoram is Mizo. Next sister, that is the sixth sister, is called as the Nagaland. Hello, I am Nagaland, one of the smallest states of India, called as Switzerland of the East. Here we have a land of folklore passed down through generations, with music as an integral part of our life. The exquisitely picturesque landscapes, the vibrantly colorful sunrise and sunset, lush and verdant flora make my land unimaginably beautiful. So here the sixth sister is called as the Nagaland. Nagaland is the smallest state of India, is called as the Switzerland of the East. Here it is a land of folklore passed through generations, with music as an integral part of our life. Here in Nagaland, music is a very important part of the people over there. Music is played as an importance over there. The state capital is Kohima. The state is mostly mountainous. So the capital of Nagaland is Kohima. The state is almost mountainous. That means it is covered with mountains. Mount Seramathi is the highest peak, with a height of about 3840 meters, and its range forms a natural barrier between Nagaland and Burma. So Mount Seramathi, is the highest mountain over there. It is about its height is about 3,840 meters, and it forms as a natural barrier between Nagaland and Burma. Because of that mountain, there is a barrier between Nagaland and Burma. There are over 16 tribes and sub-tribes that inhabit my exotic hill state, each with its own unique, colorful, and intricately designed costumes, jewelry, and beads that adorn them. So there are total how many tribes and sub-tribes? 16 tribes and sub-tribes, each with its own unique, colorful, and intricately designed costumes. That means 16 tribes and 16 sub-tribes are there. So each tribe has its own costumes, each tribe has its own design, jewelry, beads, which makes them very beautiful. Today, many of my young people have ventured into fashion designing, creating fabrics that blend our traditional motifs with modern appeal. So much so, I have become a paradise for those who are into fashion designing. People refer to me as an affluent fashion station of the East. So, there are 16 tribes and 16 sub-tribes. All tribes have their own special costumes, special jewelries, and beads that attract many people. Many of the people, young people, have gone into fashion designing, and they have created many fabric cloths and everything. My land is an ideal place for trekking, rock climbing, jungle camping, and offers limitless exploration possibilities in its lush and verdant subtropical rainforest. So people over there, they go for trekking, rock climbing, jungle camping, and lot of explore they explore lot of things over there. Here we have an abundance of medicinal herbs too. The medicinal plants are also being found in Nagaland. I am known as the Falcon Capital of the world. The great Indian hornbill is one of the most famous birds found here. So there's one famous bird called as hornbill, is the most famous bird of that state. Nagad by nature are lovers of fun and frolic, and here life is one long festival. So here life is called as the festival over there. They celebrate life, they enjoy life every day, and they enjoy each and every moment of life. So life is called as a festival over there. Dance and songs are part and parcel of all our festivities. Most of our dances are performed with a robust rhythm. That means over there, dance and songs, they are very beautifully sung by the people over there, beautifully danced by the people over there. They add a very healthy boost up to their life. If you love a colorful life and appreciate ethnic costumes, customs and traditions with their unique songs, dancing and festivals, you must come to our Naga Heritage Festival. Do come and participate in our great Hornbill Festival. This great hornbill is one of the famous bird over there. So they celebrate this as a festival, Great Hornbill Festival over there. They celebrate it with a great music and grand beauty. So over there, Nagaland, if you want to enjoy life, and if you want a colorful life, then you should go and visit Nagaland, which has its beautiful costumes and traditions. People dance a lot, songs and dance and everything. They enjoy life like anything over there. Now this is the last sister, that is the Tripura. Hello, I am Tripura, the third smallest state in the country, bordered by Bangladesh to the north, south, and west. So Tripura is the smallest, is the third smallest state in the country. All over that state, Bangladesh is being bordered. Tripura meaning three cities. Tripura also means near water. Tripura means three cities. Tripura means near water. Some scholars also believe that the land was ruled in ancient times by a king named Tripur. So, some scholars, they think that this Tripura was ruled by a king named Tripur, and so it is called as a Tripura. My land has three distinct geographical zones: the hill ranges, which run from north to south,
the undulating plateau land and the low-lying alluvial plains. Many rivers nourish my land and sustain the activities of my people. Rice, cotton, tea, tobacco are grown here. So rice, cotton, jute, tobacco and tea are very famous over there in Tripura. They are grown over there by the people over there. The Korak speaking Tripuri people are the major group among the many tribes and sub-tribes. Bengali and Manipuri people have coexisted in peaceful harmony with the people of Tripura for generations. So the Korak speaking Tripuri people, that means the Koraks, there are a tribe that speak Korak, and it is the major group over there. Majority of the people over there speak are Korak people who are speaking Tripuri language. The people over there, they live in peace and harmony. I am rather difficult for you to access because only one major road or national highway connects my land with the rest of the country. So, people find it difficult to visit Tripura as only one road is being connected with Tripura to the other states. Agartala is my capital city. So, the capital city of Tripura is Agartala. People come to visit me for ecotourism or archaeological tourism. So people only go to visit Tripura for some work purpose only. The Neer Mahal is a gorgeous red and white water palace. So Neer Mahal, it is a red and white water palace, which is a very beautiful palace over there. People of all communities and tribes participate in state festivals. So people of all communities and tribes, they participate state festivals. Whatever festivals are being celebrated in our country, India, are all being celebrated by the people of Tripura. Come and visit me. You will be fascinated by my rich cultural heritage. My folk dances will enthrall you and my people will welcome you with warmth and courtesy. So what does the people of Tripura, they want to say that? The folk dances, that means the folk dances being danced by the people of Tripura are very beautiful to watch, and whenever you will go to Tripura, the dance will automatically take you to dance with them. Their dance is so thrilling and they are so enjoyable that people will love dancing to full day. Also they will dance, but they will not get tired. Like that, their dance is there, and the people over there will always welcome with warm and courtesy. They are always friendly. They will never ignore us, or they will not at all keep us alone. They will be very friendly to us because they look other people as their own people. So this is what is all about the seven sisters that we have studied today. So students, I hope that you have understood the topic seven sisters. The topic seven sisters tell us about the beauty of the nature. As we are not able to visit over there, so the seven sisters, the writer of this lesson has dedicated to us this chapter, because we can't go and visit there. So he's telling us to enjoy the chapter by reading and listening to the story over here. What all is being famous over there, what all are found over there, and everything everything, that is the waterfalls, caves, then flora and fauna are being found over there, which is very beautiful and which is very nice to see. With the dance and music of each and every state is very enjoyable. So students, this is what the chapter is about. Students, I hope that you have understood the topic very well. Thank you. Take care, be safe, and stay healthy.